Hi, and welcome to Fall Broadcast Week 8. We're your hosts, Ranger Madison.
And Ranger Alyssa.
This week, we'll have a peak check. We will also have tips for visiting. And our special guest this week was Superintendent Pat Kenny. And Alyssa sat down to have soup with the superintendent.
I did. It was so much fun. I can't wait for you all to see that at the end. So stick around for it. So our peak check for this week is that it's still beautiful up here. Of course it is. Some of you have been asking what the park looks like after some of the weather, like the wind that we had this past weekend. And we're happy to report it is still beautiful and colorful up here. If you do come this weekend, be prepared. It's going to be a little bit colder. I think we have some freezing temps on the way. So make sure that you all come with plenty of layers and bring your camera because it's still gorgeous in the park.
Some tips for visiting this week. It's the same as it has been this whole fall season. Remember to utilize the website. There's a lot of really great information there, and it's a great way for you to plan the trip. I recommend viewing some maps and downloading them. Mm-hmm. And speaking of downloading, download the Shenandoah NPS app and make sure that you get the offline content. Mm-hmm. The service in the park is unreliable, and it's a really great resource for you to have in your pocket.
Yeah, I like to use that for all of my hiking planning, so mm-hmm. It's perfect. So we're going to go over some closures real quick. Big Meadows Campground is still open through the 11th of November. All other campgrounds are closed for the season. We do have the two lodges that are still open, and the Lewis Mountain cabins are still open. So we mentioned earlier that there's going to be some freezing temperatures in the upcoming week. So maintenance staff has been shutting off some of the water in the park. That includes in the picnic area. So mm-hmm. If you need to put out your fire, bring that jug of water, or you can search for a frost-free faucet. Those will be available in some of the picnic areas. They have turned off the water again. So some of the bathrooms are going to be closed, but not the vault toilet. So if you don't want to go behind a tree, those are still available for you. Here are some of the photos that you all contributed this week to our Flickr page. Remember, that's flickr.com/groups/shenfall. They are getting more beautiful. I love looking at those. Make sure that you include the date and location of your photo, and we'll share it right here every week.
So as you guys have probably noticed, me and Alyssa have some mugs with us. Yep. And these are full of soup for her segment with the superintendent, Soup with the Soup. So, you know, we love a good pun here at Media Team, so we had to do it. But we're doing a little quality control before the superintendent gets here. So,
Hey everyone, I am sitting here with Superintendent Pat Kenny, and we decided to do soup with the soup. And so our soup of choice today is corn chowder, and it is keeping us warm on this chilly fall day. So Pat, thank you for being here today.
Well, thank you.
Yeah, we're going to talk to you a little bit about your fall experience. So you just said that you had been here, you passed your 1 year anniversary in the park. Congratulations.
Thank you.
So tell us a little bit about what you've been doing this fall.
Yeah, it's been great. You know, a first year in a park is always fun, and it feels like this fall has been about family and friends. We've had a lot of guests, and we've got to celebrate Shenandoah and share Shenandoah with our family and friends. So that's been really great.
Yeah, it's been beautiful up here. We're so grateful for the fall that Mother Nature has given us this year. You can see there's still plenty of color around us, so we're really excited about that, too. Tell us what some of advice you would give to future visitors that are still planning on visiting this year or even next fall. What would you suggest that they do?
I think Shenandoah is a neat park. You know, it is a park of four seasons, and I think it's great that we get out and see the park in all four seasons. I mean, fall is kind of the exclamation point in our season. But I think people think of us as a fall park. But I think people should come out and see this park in all four seasons.
Absolutely. I agree with that. I actually love coming here. I love coming here in the fall for sure. But in the winter, it's just such a totally different experience that you can't get even in the spring or the summer because there's less people. And I actually see more wildlife typically because there aren't as many people, which is really, really cool.
I think it is really interesting too because we see this as in the spring and in the summer. It's mm-hmm. so green. We go through this great color change. But then it opens up, and then there's all these hidden treasures, like you said, the wildlife, but then there's the history of the park that becomes exposed, as you can see in the forest.
Yeah. So what has been your favorite part about fall so far?
Well, you obviously have to enjoy the color, first off. That's obvious. But I think I'll go back to my family and friends. I mean, being able to share the park, I think that's been one of my highlights of spending time in the national parks, is sharing the parks I've worked in with people I know and care about. And it's fun to get out and see the park and see other people sharing it. And I think fall is really a great time for that.
Yeah. Have you done any hikes or any kind of sightseeing this year?
Yeah, we've spent a little bit of time. You know, we've done kind of the classics. You know, we've done some time on the AT. We've done some Stony Man, Hawksbill, Dark Hollow Falls. But you know what's great is there's a lot of hidden gems. And I would encourage people to get out and find those. You know, if those trailheads are full, there's plenty of other hikes in this park, and I think some of the more hidden ones are kind of special from that standpoint.
Yeah, I agree.
And I'm going to keep those secrets so they can go find their own hidden gems.
Sure. I won't pressure you into telling us. You can tell me later. It's okay. So, you have been to the lodges this year.
I have.
So I have to ask, and I want you all to answer too, blackberry ice cream pie or blackberry cobbler?
Oh, cobbler, of course.
With or without ice cream?
Oh, always with ice cream. So always with ice cream.
Yes, always with ice cream. Easy answer.
Yes,
great.
It is. It's a very easy answer.
So we've had a lot of visitation this year, especially in the fall, and it's so great that we have the staff to communicate with them so that they can have a great experience here, right?
Yeah, as a relatively the new guy, I'll qualify it, but I think it's this park has a great team. Everything from the interpreters that help everybody plan their visits to the sanitation crew that keeps this place clean. We have a great team. The rangers have been very busy. We've had a few search and rescue efforts this year that have, obviously take a fair amount of time. And so I think we're just really fortunate. Shenandoah is really fortunate to have a great team.
Pat, is there anything else you'd like to add about fall 2021?
I guess the main thing I'd like to say is thank you to all the Gateway communities. I think they're a great partner for the park, and I think that they enjoy the benefits of all the visitation, and it's great to have their support from the park's perspective.
Yeah.
Yeah. So.
Thank you so much for being here today. We are going to go ahead and finish our soup and our conversation about fall in Shenandoah because we love it here so much. But thank you again, and have a nice trip here, guys, and we'll see you again next fall.
Hey, you're a diva.
I am, aren't I? I will admit that. I'm the first to admit that. Thank you again for joining us, and we'll see you next time.